Hello everyone, welcome to In Conversation, our interview series for the PMFME monthly e-newsletter. PMFME is an acronym for the Pradhan Mantri Formalization of Micro Food Processing Enterprises Scheme, a landmark initiative under the Atmanirbhar Bharat Abhiyan by the Ministry of Food Processing Industries, Government of India. To know more about the PMFME scheme, please visit www.pmfme.mofpi.gov.in. For queries related to PMFME scheme, you can call at our helpline number 9113022810089. To subscribe to our e-newsletter, please click on the link in the description below. In this episode of In Conversation, we are interacting with Dr. M.R. Dinesh, Director ICAR, Indian Institute of Horticulture Research, Bangalore. This episode is dedicated to jackfruit and jackfruit-based products. Before we delve into the world of jackfruit, I would like to tell our viewers about our guest, Dr. Dinesh. Dr. Dinesh had his BSc and MSc in horticulture and PhD in pomology, with specialization in fruit breeding from University of Agricultural Sciences, Bangalore. He joined the Indian Institute of Horticulture Research as scientist and is presently heading the institute as director. He has 30 years of experience in the breeding of fruit crops like mango, guava and papaya. Over the years, he has helped in the establishment of mango and guava field gene bank with a collection comprising of 728 varieties of mango and 70 varieties of guava. He has published catalogs on mango and papaya, had contributed to book chapters and has more than 55 research papers to his credit and has handled several foreign aided projects with external funding. He is also one of the authors who helped in developing Bioversity International Descriptor on mango and the development of DUS guidelines for mango. He is the recipient of Amrapali Award from the Society of Subtropical Horticulture and Girdhari Lal Chaddha Memorial Award for his contribution to fruit science. On behalf of Ministry of Food Processing Industries, I welcome you to In Conversation. Sir, thank you very much for taking out time from your busy schedule and interacting with us.
Thank you. Thank you very much.
Sir, could you please tell us, our viewers, about jackfruits and its importance from a nutritional standpoint?
Yeah, see, actually, of late, if you see the Indian scenario, generally what has happened is people now, there was a time when in any of the crops, we were only concentrating on yield and to certain extent productivity.
Yes, sir.
Now, the shift has come in all the crops with regard to productivity. Mm-hmm. Now, we are concerned with more of the nutritional security, having met the food target. Mm-hmm. Now, the nutritional security can come from some of these horticultural crops. Mm-hmm. We know that India is the hotspot of biodiversity for many of the fruit crops. And incidentally, the primary center of origin of jackfruit is the Western Ghats region. So mm-hmm. what has happened is jackfruit is one such tree wherein not much exploitation has been carried out with regard to its commercial importance. It has been actually our Southeast nation neighbors. They have exploited jackfruit much better than what we have done. However, having said that, traditionally, if you see, be it the Northeast or the Southwest, especially the coastal region of Karnataka, Kerala, Tamil Nadu, right up to Maharashtra, and then the Northeastern region of India, both these sectors, if you go and see, lot many traditional products are there for jackfruit. This is one part of it. Second thing is, if you see, the jackfruit, it is mainly an unorganized cultivation. It is not an organized cultivation. So the importance is that now we need to exploit it because there is a fantastic diversity for this particular crop. And already we have got the traditional knowledge with regard to that. That is the second point. Third thing is, nutritionally, if you see jackfruit, it is a fantastic source of potassium, then phenols, then vitamin C, both mature, ripe ones and the immature fruit. Both are actually treasure house of nutrients. In fact, the glycemic index which even diabetic people can consume. In some of the cases, what has happened is jackfruit, some of the varieties of jackfruit, from the preliminary understanding what we have got of the chemical profiling what we have done, it could also bring down the sugar content. In fact, the immature jackfruit powder, pulp powder or seed powder is known to reduce the sugar content in the blood. So there are so much nutritional treasure house. It can be called as a nutritional treasure house.
Sir, if I ask, where do you see India on a global level in terms of jackfruit processing industry compared to the other countries across the world?
Yeah, in processing in itself is actually a sunrise sector, and the government has done fantastic job in giving some of the schemes to the for people to become entrepreneurs. Now when we look at the processing industry and the status of jackfruit processing, only till recent, we can take the history of only about 5 years when it has really assumed the commercial importance with regard to small scale industries with varied products. These products have come about from the traditional knowledge. Although they have now become commercial, it is basically the traditional knowledge. Now let us say whether papad making from jackfruit, immature jackfruit, use of seeds, although it was there earlier. Now we are making seed powder. Now we are making immature jackfruit pulp powder. Now we have got into organized sector of processing industry in a very, very small scale. There is a lot of exploitation of this area which can be done in the near future. In fact, if you go to the coastal regions starting from Karnataka, Kerala up to Maharashtra, lot many small scale industries have come with so many products. I think this is the right time to start it in a very big way, and globally India can definitely exploit because the bearing season varies between other nations and India, and the vast diversity that we have got should be exploited in various places. It can ensure better employment in the villages. It can ensure better nutritional security for the masses. And it can also be a very good industry paying the entrepreneur very well.
Sir, as we already know, in North India, jackfruit often ends up as a vegetable or sabzi in our plates. However, there are ample opportunities for value addition in both firm and soft type of jackfruit in all stages of maturity, right from the immature to the well-ripened stage. Sir, what are your thoughts on the value addition of jackfruit that micro entrepreneurs can explore?
Yeah, I think there are lot many products. As I said before, I think raw material is abundantly available. First point number one is that when raw material is available indigenously in such a large quantity, then that is the first plus point that for a processing industry or a small scale processing industry. Now, having said that, there are many, many, in fact, very, very successful entrepreneurs like Mrs. Vinutha Hegde, and we have very recently come across one industry in Puttur, Nitya Foods, who are doing small scale this kind of jackfruit. Then there is one Sridhar Ogle who has done modak out of this jackfruit. There are many, many examples like this. Having said that, I think you value added products like chips, the beauty of jackfruit is that the variety of products that you can generate from a single fruit is amazing. Be it ripe fruit, as ripe fruit can be used even for payasam in some of the areas, and are being used in some of the areas, and this can also be exploited. Seed powder, which is very good for protein, as a good source of protein. In fact, I am very, very happy to share with you that our institute has come out with three very good products of jackfruit. And there are many, many industries who have exploited this value addition, because in the case of jackfruit, you can have lost many products starting from seed, pulp, like dried jackfruit you can have. You can have vacuum frying, you can have. Then you can have osmotic dehydration, you can have. Then ready to serve jackfruit beverages. There are so many things are there in that. apart from that, our institute has come out with three products. Like juice we have come out with, we have come out with cookies, and we have come out with chocolates. So there is a fact, I don't see any other fruit which is having the kind of opportunity for value-added products like jackfruit.
Sir, could you please tell us about interesting trends that you have observed over time in jackfruit processing industry and share some insights about the future of the industry?
Actually, what has happened is very, very interesting facts in the recent past is generally any processing industry. I told you that the raw material is not a problem. But having said that, the actual issue is any processing industry. Supposing you come out with a product, value-added product for jackfruit, any processing industry, for example, what they want is uniformity in the raw material. Now, basically, we are actually concentrating on many varieties, which are basically of the seedling origin. Now, in the past 5 years, what has happened is slowly and steadily, the jackfruit commercial plantings are coming under orchard systems, wherein mainly grafts of one particular variety, a seedling which has been selected, this is getting promoted. So in the years to come, you will definitely get jackfruit products from a uniform material. Because what happens is that for an entrepreneur, if the even though raw material is abundantly available, the uniformity of raw material is extremely important to come out with products of uniform range. So that is not, to a certain extent, is not happening in jackfruit. That can happen in the years to come because of jackfruit getting into organized cultivation in commercial orchards.
Sir, could you please tell us about the kind of jackfruit-based research and development carried out at IIHR and shed some light on interesting case studies or success stories that you have come across in all these years and are very groundbreaking?
Yeah, actually, over a period of time, we have been working on jackfruit. We have been collecting jackfruit, in fact. What we have done is we have built up a gene bank of jackfruit first. Because otherwise we would lose some of these very good varieties for reasons which are beyond our control. So what we have done first is we have tried to build up a very good field gene bank of varieties, which are basically grafted materials. And from that, now having done that, now we are getting into the post-harvest product line and the processing line. In that, what we have done is we have come out with three very good products. One is known as Arka Halasuras. Arka is incidentally the registered trademark of our institute because we are located on the banks of the river Arkavati. We have taken the first few letters of Arkavati river, and now every product from the institute gets the prefix Arka. So this Arka products we have in jackfruit. One is a chocolate made with seed powder as well as mushroom powder, dried mushroom powder. Then the second product is cookies, which is also made from the same combination. Then the third one is Arka Halasuras. Halasu in Kannada is jackfruit. So what we have done is this Halasuras is basically a product which can be kept at ambient temperature for about 6 months. It doesn't have any added sugar. It doesn't have any added preservative in it. So it can be kept for about 6 months. So this is one very good product. Now we have commercialized these products to few of the companies. As I told you, there is one Nitya Foods who actually were mixing jackfruit powder with the chapati, wheat powder. So what was happening was they were unable to get the correct standardized chapati out of this mixture. He sells about 20,000 chapatis per day. This Nitya Foods, which is located in Karnataka, down south in towards the coastal region of Karnataka. Now he has, we helped him with the product. I've standardized the product, and now he mixes the jackfruit seed powder with the wheat powder. This is very, very helpful for diabetic patients. This is one very good thing. So this we have standardized. Now he has also picked up our chocolate and cookies. there is one woman entrepreneur who has picked up this chocolate from us, technology from us. It is costing about 50,000 rupees or so. What we do is, as a single window of Institute Technology Management Unit, we sell these technologies for a period of 5 years on a non-exclusive basis. Any number of entrepreneurs can take these technologies. And once they take the technologies for 5 years, we don't ask for the royalty also. It is one-time down payment. And the technology gets, once they start doing the technology and selling it, we also handhold them for about 6 months in the institute. We have incubation facility here. So we handhold them for about 6 months. So this is the kind of arrangement we have. Now, there are many, and some of the entrepreneurs have done very well. In fact, the institute had organized one national horticultural fair with the theme Startup and Stand-up India, both on a physical and virtual mode. About 54 lakh people viewed this NHF, National Horticultural Fair. And the physical fair was also there, wherein we had displayed about 255 technologies of the institute in the field. We have also got varieties of various vegetable crops. We have got biopesticides. We have got so many plant protection. Like that, we had post-harvest products also. And this entrepreneur, lady entrepreneur, sold about 15 kg of chocolates within 4 days. So this is the kind of opportunity that they are having through the products of institute products. In fact, we are also in the process of developing few more products from this jackfruit. There are many number of entrepreneurs who are coming forward. Their advantage here is that although, as I told you, uniformity of material is not there, raw material is abundantly available. And in fact, jackfruit, it is well spread in Western Ghat region as well as in the drier regions of Karnataka, wherein we have got a lot of varieties with coppery red flakes. These are known as, these are in the dry regions of Karnataka. In fact, one of the fantastic examples I can quote to you, apart from the value-added products, of course, we have also started value-added products from these coppery red flake varieties of jackfruit. What we have done is, since the biodiversity is so huge, there is a tendency from the people, sometimes we say that we are doing because of some other purpose, they may cut down the trees. Now, what we have done is, during our survey, we have found one of the farmers having a very good variety with a very high lycopene content in the case of jackfruit. This variety has got coppery red flakes, and we helped the farmer to understand the grafting methodology. We got into an MOU with the farmer. We told him that we will promote it as a farmer's variety. On his father's name, we named it as Siddhu Halasu. And then we are promoting it. And the farmer, what we did was, he was not knowing grafting. So we trained him in grafting. In the first 2 years, institute started grafting. And every plant sold, if we charge 100 rupees, 75 rupees would go to his account and 25 rupees would come to our account. So like that, we gave him 5 lakh rupees in 1 year, and now he is earning about 20 to 25 lakhs per year. So this, so now the person, even if you ask him to cut the tree, he will not cut. So this is how we can exploit the biodiversity and link it to livelihood security, so that not only will we be helping the farmers, the institute technology gets popularized, as well as the environmental cause we are helping. So in fact, we are also trying to now develop products from this particular variety of jackfruit. In fact, I would like to take the name of one Mr. Sri Padre, who in Karnataka has done wonderful work with regard to campaigning for the jackfruit products. And what we also do is, every year we conduct jackfruit diversity fairs. So we ask all the farmers to bring the jackfruit samples, whatever they are having, and they will bring it and they will keep it here so that it gets displayed. About 500 types would get displayed. The best one variety we will choose, and we will promote the farmer through that.
Sir, how would you describe the technological contribution of IIHR to the jackfruit processing industry in India?
I'm very happy to share with you that many of our products, especially these three products, are catching up very well, and we have licensed it to about 5 to 6 companies now. So the jackfruit in India itself is a very, very nascent processing industry. Having said that, I am hopeful that down the line in another 5 years, definitely not only our products, I think products from various other places would also come in and would change the scenario. In fact, I for one who always believes that this jackfruit products, value added products, can definitely get into the midday meal scheme of the school children, because this is one which can be, juice can be given, very nutritious, chocolates can be given, which also has got mushroom powder in it. So this is one part which needs to be very, very seriously taken view of, which not only would promote jackfruit value added industry, processing industry, but also would help many of the processing industry entrepreneurs who are doing mushroom.
Sir, what would be your advice to the aspiring entrepreneurs who are planning to venture into the domain of jackfruit processing?
My advice or message would be that this is the right time to get into entrepreneurship through jackfruit. Why? Because there is a very vast scope of export in this particular crop. Right from chips to papad to juice making, you have varied products which can definitely be taken, and we can export it. In fact, there are attempts which has been made to export it. I wish and hope that it would catch up very well with the Western world. Already few people are trying it out. In fact, there are many Westerners who are coming and asking about the products here. So I think especially the chocolates, they have great future in my opinion, so that India can emerge as one of the best value-added product making nation with regard to jackfruit. In fact, I should share with you that some of the Southeast nations like Vietnam have made fantastic headway. Why they have made headway is because of their packaging industry. I think we need to devote enough attention apart from processing value-added products to also to packing. It is the packing which makes many products sell very well in the outside market. So we have to pay a lot of attention for packing. Biodegradable packages, yes, we need to develop. On a small scale, it has started. Probably in the years to come, down the line, a couple of years down the line, I am hopeful that a lot of biodegradable packaging material also would come. And jackfruit entrepreneurs will get umpteen number of opportunities. It is a very nascent industry. And one of the most important aspects here is that this jackfruit, across the crops, everybody is worried about climate change. But fortunately, jackfruit is one crop. Irrespective of the climate you have in the places of its growth, it gives very good fruiting and the yield is excellent here.
With the immense experience that you have gathered over the period of time in food processing sector, according to you, what are some of the areas in which the micro food processing enterprises need support in jackfruit processing? And how do you think the PMFME scheme would be able to support micro food processing enterprises in these areas?
Yes, I think there are two very, very important which are connected with this micro processing, which both are being addressed by the government. That is one very, very plus point here. See, the two sectors like the FPOs, farmer producer organizations, are extremely important. Point number one. Point number two is self-help women groups. There are umpteen number of them doing many, many products in their own way. Self-help groups in Madhya Pradesh, self-help groups in Karnataka, in Andhra Pradesh, so many states, they are doing very good work. Now, what we need to do is we have to make them aware of the kind of products that they can make out of jackfruit. That is why I said jackfruit fairs must be organized in various places, in the places of its diversity, so that people would come to know about the diversity what we are having. This micro processing, I personally feel jackfruit is one of the ideal candidates for it. This scheme would support jackfruit processing like anything, because consumption in India is not at all a problem. Leave alone export. First, let us concentrate within the huge Indian market. Let us push this product. Outside, always there is a chance. we can definitely, through this scheme, it is a very good fillip for FPOs and self-help groups, farmers, producers, organizations, if not individuals. FPOs, yeah, in fact, in the institute, we are trying to have an FPO exclusively with jackfruit producing people. We want to promote it in such a way that they, not only would they organize jackfruit selling properly, but they also would get into the processing part of it. And I'm sure these schemes would support them in a very, very great way. Be it incubation, in fact, the institutes can start incubation centers, and then the FPOs and the self-help groups can take advantage of the scheme.
Sir, thank you very much for interacting with us and enlightening us on this subject. I really hope our viewers would be inspired and love to know more about jackfruit processing. Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
I welcome all the people to come to the institute, visit us, see what kind of products we have developed. They can also become entrepreneurs. We will try to handhold them, and also we'll try to link them up with the market. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much. If you have enjoyed this episode of In Conversation, do leave a comment. We would love to hear from you. Please do share the episode and help us reach to everyone. Do subscribe to our newsletter and follow PMFME on Facebook and Twitter.